Yaya. Let me see who Yaya is. I like that little Playboy bunny, Yaya. Okay, we follow each other now. I'm loving you, and you loving you. It's easy, cause you're beautiful. Do 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 do, yeah. Ooh, I got you, baby. What's up, Scoober? We here, man. Welcome back. This is tailgate week. We waiting on 3 stars, though. So unless Vigo come up in this bitch and throw the rest of these stars, we just gonna have to hold out for a moment. Yeah. One of these admin. Vigo admins, I need you. I need you, Vigo admins. Because we gotta have 3 stars. She is Chef Boy Ty, my nigga. Y'all, please follow Chef Boy Ty. Man, I'm telling you, the king of the seafood boil, man, that's my partner. And the king of the fashion, the king of designer, the king of the seasons. Like, he do so much. He the jack of all trades. Please follow my partner. Yeah, y'all tell him, throw the beans. Don't be mean. We need 3 stars. My hologram just so happens to run off plutonium. So I need you. Chef Boy Ty, alright, do you feel me, man? I love buffalo dip too. You feel me? And we finna get into it. We finna go right into the kitchen, but we gotta have 3 stars. We 800 diamonds away. Hey, because this hologram run off plutonium, and the price of plutonium done went up. So high, sky high. Huh? Done ran my light bill up sky high. The price of the plutonium it did. So we gotta get 3 stars before we can get the thing crack-a-lacking. Until then, I'm very pleased to meet everybody in the motherfucking comment. Zara, what's going on, man? Good morning. Everybody follow my nigga Chef Ty. Hey, welcome to tailgate week, nigga. I'm finna equip you for all your tailgate needs. Is that Unicort? Hey! Unicort up in it, bitch. Go Court. I wish you could see me swinging Big Pickle, but I can't come on the screen until we get 3 stars. I wish you could see me swinging Big Pickle, baby, but I cannot come out unless we get 3 stars, boy. All this pickle and no eyes to feast upon. All of this pickle and no eyes to feast upon. God damn it. Ayy. You say you like that little spinning thing in the middle? That's my hologram. Yeah, that's the thing that I was telling you run off plutonium. Ooh, plutonium so high. Ooh, that shit higher than jet fuel. You know, but I can't put jet fuel in it because the shit don't work right. It only works off plutonium. So, yeah. Gotta put a down payment on Chef's plutonium for the hologram, you know? Shit. You know? This bitch run off 141 gigabytes or some shit with the dudes, huh? Yeah, it costs a lot of money. So I'm gonna need y'all to tap that screen. Share the live. Tell a friend to tell a friend. If you ain't got no damn beans, you better get your ass somewhere and share it with somebody with some beans. We need 3 stars so we can get this thing cock-a-lane. Ay. Oh. Hey, Chef Boy, I will text you. Y'all follow my dude, man. That's my partner right there. Y'all follow Chef Boy Ty, nigga. Gaze in the kiss. Yeah, follow me. Who said that? Who you? Who sent you? Who you? Who this hoppo? Who is this woman? Hoppo, who is this woman? Ike, who is this woman? Okay, I'm gonna follow you too. Thanking you. Hey, y'all come on in, man. This is Chef Kendall's Kitchen. I appreciate every last one of you. We need 3 stars to open up the kitchen. Shit, Bigo admins, you better throw some diamonds. How can you just leave me standing alone in the world that's so cold? Bigo admins, I need you. Maybe I'm just too demanding, huh? Maybe. Or maybe I'm just like my father. Maybe I'm too cold. Or maybe I'm just like my mother, you know? Cause she was never satisfied. But Bigo admins, I'm telling you, I can't get shit started without 3 stars. And this is what it sounds like when Chef cries. Y'all ain't gonna throw me shit. Goddamn. Damn, I thought I was loved. I thought I would be loved. Okay, Court, I do appreciate you. Hey, Poppy Wiz, what's up, nigga? Hey, Rick and Mommy, Deco, my baby. skies are tall. Oh shit, we at 3 stars. Even does have cries. Yeah, come on. Alone in the world is so cold. Maybe I'm just too demanding. Maybe I'm just like my father, too cold. Maybe I'm just like my mother. She never said, at each other. I can do both parts. This is what it sound like when dude cry. I appreciate you niggas. I was getting in the groove. Y'all done missed the whole 15-minute segment of the show. We are here, nigga. What's going on? He say, what? War Eagle, I fuck with them too. I fuck with all Alabama football, nigga. Go Blazers, Roll Tide, and War Eagle, nigga. What you talking about? I'm from Bama. I'm a real Alabamian. Shit. Now, let's get. I did. Follow your hot ass. Shut your ass. Let me speak to all of y'all. Let me go into the bubbles. I did follow you, motherfucker. Looky, looky, looky. Here goes Cookie. Big Chef got some beautiful viewers in the room. I got my lovely wifey up in this bitch. Hey, I got the nigga Hot up in here. What's going on, Hot? Ooh, you already know Unicorn is here with Big Chef. I appreciate you, Court. What's going on? Poppy Wiz, what's going on? Bad Gang, what's going on? How you say your name? So tight. Damn it, my big ass fingers be pressing the wrong shit. Young Print, what's up, my nigga? Toya, I love you, me some you, baby. Luscious Lexi, good morning, honey bunny. What's going on, man? Miss Badass Puff. Nene God with the baby hairs. What's going on? Wiz, what's happening? Bitch, is that bitch or birch? Okay, Mimi, what's going on? T Mika, hey, hey, hey. Mocha, hey, hey, hey. Tammy, hey, hey, hey. What up? Hey, hey, hey. All right, man. That's everybody I recognize in this motherfucker. Now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages and sizes, animals and plants. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm the motherfucking one. I'm that one in 1 million. I'm the one that your mama warned you about. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Chef Kendall. How are you doing? Pleased to meet you. Pleased to make your acquaintance. How your mama now? Hold on, hold on. AKA Bob. Big Chef is definitely in the motherfucking cut. Nigga what? And ladies and gentlemen, I'm the people's champ on this app. I fight for the people. I fight for the real content. And if it ain't Kendall, it's a motherfucking swindle, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Kendall 3 times. That is Chef Kendall, Chef Kendall, Chef Kendall. Name so nice. Name so motherfucking nice. You just can't say it once. You just can't say it twice. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you got to say that motherfucker thrice. And I'm a bad man. Let me tell you all about it. I sell water to a well. And I sell slick to a motherfucking snail. Ladies and gentlemen, I am the only cow in the pasture with one titty. Let me repeat. Ladies and gentlemen, I am the only bovine in the pasture with one titty. That gives plenty of milk, motherfucker. I am the one, the only, the OG, the original, the O to the motherfucking G. Yeah, that's me. I am Chef Kendall. To the sky, baby. To infinity and beyond. And it's time for another motherfucking morning show. It's time to come on off in Chef Kendall's kitchen. I appreciate y'all. We almost at 400 people. We got the three star requirement. It's time to get tailgate week started. Sit your ass tight. Get your pens. Get your pads. Get your handy dandy thinking caps. I'm about to show you the best fucking buffalo chicken dip recipe of your life. Come in. Hey, come on. Get up. Do it like it hurt. Like it hurt. To the I'd like to welcome y'all back to the motherfucking kitchen. Roll Tide, roll. All Alabama football on roof for you. But the home, I'm T-Town, baby. I'm in Birmingham, but I'm from T-Town, so you gotta go with the Tide, baby. Hey, let's get into tailgate week, but before we even lift off into that, because I know you're here for some quick tailgate shit. I know you need it. Everybody needs it. Everybody that's a sports lover loves it and needs it. Before we get into that, let me introduce you to the one to make this shit possible, my nigga. I'm talking about, if this was Def Comedy Jam, she would be the Russell Simmons, nigga. The beautiful wifey.
Hey, good morning, everybody. Grand Risings family, thank you so much for joining us. Make sure you keep tapping the screen. I see y'all tapping this morning. Share the live, share to Facebook, and share to Twitter. Don't let this be the best kept secret on Bego. We need you.
Hey.
Come on in the room, y'all. Come on in the room. It's time to start tailgate week, baby. It's going down all this week. August the 9th through August the 13th.
Yes.
Tune in all week, baby. It's going down. It's going down, y'all.
Yes. Make sure you tune in and check out the grand finale. It's going to be a seafood boil by Chef Kendall. You know how I get down. All respect to Chef Boy Ty. Huh? Ty Boy, hey, y'all. All respect to Chef Ty. That's my nigga. And he the king of that shit. But, see, Big Chef. Big Chef get down himself, man. So the grand finale is going to be a seafood boil. I'm going to teach you how to make your own seafood boil season the way that I do. I'm going to give you my recipe for seafood boil. Like, my secret. Like, this is the shit that had Phaedra Parks over there. You know how beautiful it is to sit with your wife and watch Phaedra Parks suck her fingers? Chef Kendall, name so nice, she said. Huh? Not to mention the many people of the Bag family and in the IC Bag family and agency that I done cooked for, like, they know. So I'm going to give you the secret to my seafood boil. The finale is Friday. The way Bego got it going, to get the first part of the show is going to be during my show. The second part is going to be on a private key party sponsored by Bego ass. Bego is setting up a private key party. We're going to do the finale. You get to see the rest of the show. You get the rest of the ingredients. You get the entirety. You come and be a special gifter during this tailgate weekend. We're going to set you up with the passcode. And you're going to get to peep the whole finale. You know what I'm saying? So, shit. Throw them gifts, man. Run that shit up. Tap the screen. Share the live. And be one of the lucky ones to get in the key room. Because I heard they're going to let Chef only cook in the apron. Now, what I heard in the key room, they're going to let Big Chef cook in only the apron. So come through. It's going down. No, I'm just, wifey, I know that's you.
That's my first key.
Hey! You got the key to my heart. You don't need no key to the damn key room. Shit. In a cold sweat. Hey. Okay, then. Wifey doing all the heavy lifting on the live. I need y'all to at least throw a few beans in the treasure box. Tap that screen and share this motherfucker. Let's go ahead and get to the recipe. Now, we can do this shit one or two ways. We can do it fancy or we can do it quick. We can do it fancy or we can do it quick. Both of them gonna be good as fuck. So it's on you what type of taste you're looking for. So I'm gonna tell you what's fancy. I'm gonna tell you what's quick. We're gonna need rotisserie chicken. The best way to do it, in my opinion, is to rotisserie your chicken in your own stove, Dutch oven, bake you some chicken. You don't have to have a rotisserie grill. Bake it in the oven. The best way is to do it fresh yourself. Just fresh. Because fresh, yes, fresh is always best. Because fresh is always best. So that's the fancy way. You want to be quick and still delicious? Guess what I found out recently? You may have already known this. I don't go to Walmart every day. They have their rotisserie chickens. And I do believe in Walmart's rotisserie chickens. I watch the motherfuckers on the rotisserie grill. I watch them cook them. They're delicious. They are done right. I like Walmart's rotisserie chickens. They take the meat from those chickens that they don't use, or maybe they cook some just for this. But they get the damn chicken meat, and they pull it off the chicken, and they chop this shit up. Ayy! Ayy! Clap for that, motherfucker! Because shit, if I went to Walmart and got a rotisserie chicken, I need about a pound and a half of meat. I had to get about 2 rotisserie chickens and remove either just the breast. You can do all breast meat, pull the skin off and do breast meat. Or you can pull all the skin off and do breast meat, thigh meat, wing meat, all the meat. Dark and white. It's good. Thigh meat got the most flavor in it. But it takes a longer time. So if you would go to Walmart, this is the same chicken. This is the same chicken. And they just did the work. But if you don't have that in your area, you don't want to do that, you can always go in the oven and do your own rotisserie chicken. Okay. That's one. We're going to need an onion. I got a leftover onion that I was chopping on for some other shit. I'm going to use this onion. It's white. You can use a yellow onion. What else? Because we're going to put some flavor in here. Now, this is delicious. Fuck, nigga. It's delicious. This shit here good. It good. That boy's like, it good. That good. That boy can sign. Yeah, it's really good. It's really good. But we gonna add some flavor. Why not add a little bit of cooked onions in there? I don't know. If you don't like onions, omit. What else we gonna do? I've taught you how to make ranch seasoning. I've taught you how to make ranch seasoning, and I've taught you how to make a throw 'em. I've taught you how to make ranch from that ranch seasoning. You can do it that way. That's the fancy way. Because we're going to need about a cup of ranch. And we're going to need some ranch seasoning. You can use my recipe, make your own ranch seasoning. And you can use my recipe and make your own ranch. And that's going to fancy things up quite a bit. Yeah. We also going to need about a half a cup or so of blue cheese dressing. Like I said, I've given you the recipe for blue cheese dressing. We've made it on my live a couple of times. I think I got some bomb-ass blue cheese dressing. But if you want to be quick, these are appetizers for the game, baby. We ain't got all day. I do realize that everybody's not a chef. Everybody ain't trying to be no fucking chef. Up folk got other shit to do. I get that. So I'm going to give it to you easy. Instead of using my seasoning, you can get some ranch seasoning from Hidden Valley Ranch. You can get the blue cheese dressing, the ranch in the bottle. It's still going to be good as fuck. Don't worry about it. Oh, chef, but I want it to be great. It's still going to be great, all right? It's still going to be great. What we going to use for cheese is... Oh, we in the air with the cheese, man. Because you can go where you want to go. Look, I just want you to choose your cheeses based on what you're looking for. Big Chef is looking for a cheese that has some awesome-ass taste. A cheese that pairs up with chicken perfectly. Everybody know cheddar make it better. So I think I got some cheddar off top. That's gotta go on there. Whether you use sharp, extra sharp, mild, medium. I got medium. Gotta have that cheddar, man. You don't have to, but I really feel like chicken and cheddar and bacon, that shit make love all day. Okay? So we add in that cheddar for the taste. For a more melty creaminess, I'm gonna add some Monterey Jack. Okay, I'm gonna add some Monterey Jack. It could have been Pepper Jack. That's just Monterey Jack with peppers in it. It could have been mozzarella. Why not choose? So I got some mozzarella in the cooler. Why not use some mozzarella and put some of that in there? And that's going to give you that stretchy pool. That stretchy pool. It's going to be real stringy. Pretty to the eye, especially if you're trying to do something on the live and you want to get an awesome video or a picture, put some of that mozzarella in there. Dig in there and lift up. It's going to give you an amazing pool. Now, I will be using Monterey Jack, cheddar, and I'm gonna be using some blue cheese crumble. If you are not a fan of blue cheese, if you ain't a fan of blue cheese, please omit all blue cheese in this recipe, and it's still busting. Them motherfuckers still busting. You hear me? We gonna use a cup of ranch and a half a cup of the blue cheese. You don't fuck with blue cheese? Let's do a cup and a half of ranch. It's still good. Omit the crumbles. It's still good. All right. I say, we got a few more ingredients. Hey, thank you. Appreciate you. We got a few more ingredients. Room temperature, cream cheese. This is still a little
rainmaker.
This is still a little cool, but room temperature cream cheese. We gonna use 2 blocks of that. I'm giving you the ingredients now. You know what I'm saying? I don't know when you might have to leave the live or whatever. I'm going ahead and giving you the ingredients now. It's not a hard thing to make. Of course we're gonna use Frank's Red Hot Sauce. This is the way that I was taught to make it. This is like traditional. Ever since I've been making buffalo dip or any variation of that, it starts with classic Frank's Red Hot Sauce. You can use whatever you want. You can have whatever you like. So you can have But I will keep it classic. I'm keeping this shit classic and traditional. I'm sticking with Frank's. We're gonna need at least a cup. Frank's ain't hot enough. That ain't no damn buffalo. Okay, add cayenne to your recipe, and that'll spice it on up if you don't think Frank's. And honestly, Frank's makes an extra hot. Look for the Frank's extra hot. But this is what I'm using. That's what I'm using. Fuck that. I love Frank's. That's my go-to. We're also, you can pair your dip up with whatever you want. Tortilla chips. Lay's Ridges. Breadsticks. I'll be making crostinis. It's just the baguette. We're going to cut them thin. Make them into little toast. All right? We're going to put them in the oven with a little bit of olive oil. A little bit of, maybe even a little bit of garlic and olive oil. Put them in the oven, bake them up a little bit. Get them good and toasted and sturdy. Because we're going to need something sturdy to get into this dip and lift up in this dip, okay? So, I'll be using baguettes. All right, now we can get some shit on the road. All right. Now, I'm going to go ahead and turn on my skillet because I'm going to need to start grilling some onions. Wifey, okay, I got my little butter. Okay, you're going to need a little bit of butter. You don't have to have butter. I'm using butter. It has a little bit more flavor in it. You're going to need a little chunk of butter. You don't have to use that though. I think that this chicken is good and broke up into even pieces. Thank you, Wally World. Thank you, Wally World. Walmart, thank you. You finally did something right, you son of a bitch. You finally did something right. Fuck, you get on my nerves. I wish I could stop going to you. Yes, I mean it, Wall. No, I don't mean it. If you sponsor me, I take it all back.
Okay.
I take it all back if you sponsor me. Now, let's chop up this onion, man. We gonna need it. We're gonna need it. You can use a yellow onion. You can use a Vidalia sweet onion. That's fine. I don't have no problem with that. Just the onion. No purple. Let's not use the purple one. You know? Let's not use the purple one. This onion looks I already cut this onion, huh?
A little bit probably.
Yep, look. Look, normally, when I'm cutting onions, they do not automatically dice like this. This was cut on another day, and I don't want you to be like, woo, shit, I want to buy that nigga knife. He sliced that shit, and it diced automatic, nigga, woo, big shell. No, this onion is already, I already cut it on another day, I guess. I already cut that shit on another day. That's good. Now, this one ain't cut. Cut your onion however you want to. If you want, Walmart and most grocery stores have veggies already cut for you. It's such a goddamn waste of time for them to do that, but they got this shit already cut for you, mm-hmm. and they charge you a price.
Don't buy that. We discussed that last time.
Yeah, we talked about that.
That's nasty.
You can use that. Don't mean that.
You do use these. That's the funniest video ever.
You do too use these. All right. We got good onion. Let's hurry up and put a little chunk of butter in here, man. I like the flavor of Kerrygold. Feel good. Da-da-da-da-da. It feel good.
Yeah.
It feel good.
Thank y'all so much for joining us this morning. This is Tailgate Week. Make sure you keep tapping the screen, keep sharing the live. We need you.
Hell yeah.
Share to Facebook and share to Twitter, baby.
Turn me up with my headphones, wifey. Yeah. Get that butter in there. We just want to soften this up a little bit. Now, while you waiting on that, make sure you're using room temperature cream cheese. You don't have to, but it sure makes the job a lot easier. If you can get your cream cheese room temperature. This is a little cold, but it's still soft as hell. It's a little cold. I've had it out over an hour. That's good. Let's take this shit up. Let's go ahead and prep up our stuff. This does not take long, and it tastes fucking amazing. Our ranch. We're gonna need a cup of ranch. I feel it all over me. Yep, let's do a whole cup of ranch. Damn, that's almost a whole bottle. That's almost a whole fucking bottle. Cup of ranch. Let's do a half a cup of the blue cheese. You do not have to use bottled products. You don't have to use bottled products. You can use my recipe and you can make this homemade. Even better. We're going to use a whole cup of the hot sauce. Whole cup of this hot sauce, okay? Look at God. That's all I had, too. Shit. Stir. We just want to soften it up a little bit. All right. Now we're going to add the chicken. We want to use about a pound and a half, man. About a pound and a half. All right, that's good. Get this all broke down. It's already cut up. I'm gonna just chop up on the bigger pieces. We're gonna heat all this up. All of this is going in the oven in the end, man. All of this is gonna go in the oven in the end. While that's twerkling, I want to get my cheeses ready. Well, you know what? Let's add a little season to that. Let's add a little season to it while it's cooking. Then we're going to get our cheeses ready. Here we go with the ranch seasoning pack. If you notice, some of these ingredients are like shit that I just used. I needed something where I could get rid of this shit. I needed to get rid of that extra chicken. I needed to get rid of this damn ranch dry mix. If you have my recipe for ranch, I suggest you use that one. You don't have to. If you don't have my recipe, look, this is fine. This is supposed to be easy. Everybody ain't trying to be a fucking chef, you know? And I get that. Get that on in there. Cook some of that in there. We got the onions. We got the chicken. We got that good-ass ranch seasoning in there. Huh? If you got my ranch recipe, please use it.
Lipstick doll, thank you so much, baby.
Hey, what's happening with you, the beautiful lipstick doll? I appreciate every gorgeous person that comes through the live, man. Y'all make the nigga live so popular. Y'all follow all the beautiful gazelles. All the pretty girls on Chef Kendall's live are known as beautiful little gazelles. Prance around on the live with their little tails flipped up, you feel me? They come here because they know I ain't gonna try to fuck them. And that's what's up. You know, you don't have to automatically be friends with a gay guy. Straight guys will be your friend too, you know what I'm saying? Straight guys will be your friend. Oh, y'all nigga running from us like we got some. Come on now. Don't do that. Come be my friend. I ain't gonna try to fuck you.
Okay.
I know they tired of folks trying to fuck them all day. You get tired of that shit after a while. Too much of a good thing is a bad thing. You know?
These things are true.
Like, you always want to fuck me. Hell yeah. Now, let's warm up some cream cheese. This shit's still a little cold, you know? It's still a little cold. So, I'm going to go in here like this. Because it could have been a lot softer than this, for real. I ain't do right. Big Chef ain't do right. Big Chef ain't do right. Let's break some of that on up in there. That heat is going to help melt it down anyway, so we ain't tripping. We ain't really tripping. Get it on in there, man. That heat going to break it on down. That's why Chef don't give a damn. I know you was like, Chef, you didn't let it get room temperature. I'm Chef. I don't have to let nothing get room temperature. I'm Chef. You need to let yours get room temperature.
Nola Ling Ling, hey baby.
Hell yeah. Nola, you too. You need to let yours get room temperature. Don't do what Big Chef be doing.
Do as I say, not as I
do. Do as I say and not as I do. Uh-huh. Don't ask me why. Don't ask me why. Just do it. Yeah, get that in there. I got this heat turned down too, guys. I got the heat turned down. I don't want to cook my cream cheese yet. I want to bake it. I don't want to fry it in this pan, though. Look how soft that is getting. Look how all of that is beginning to come together. If we hadn't did it and it was completely room temperature, it would have came together so creamy, so smooth, so fast. But, you know, Big Chef got a hard head, huh? And wifey love that hard head too, don't you, wifey? Love you some hard head. Shit, so, you know? All right, are you ready? Let me see. Baby, you'll bring me one of my little, I want to be able to scoop inside of these and get all of this good shit out of here. I turn my pan all the way down, okay, guys? I turn my pan all the way down. How much time we got? We got time. I could have put some more chicken in this motherfucker. What that? No, you good. You brought me the right thing. Thank you. Now, let's add in a little bit of ranch. A whole cup, please, if you don't mind. Wait a minute. Get on the good foot. Yeah. Get on the good foot. Break it down on the... Yeah. I like a sex machine. I'm a sex machine. Anime said, poke it. Show me your dance. I said, thanks, anime. Hey, that's my shit, man. Poke it, Bell. Hey, Get all that in there, y'all. Then I heard the DJ say, poke it one more time. Get on the good foot. Get on the good foot. Hey,
break down on
the scene, baby. I like a sex machine. I'm a sex machine. Get on the good foot. Yeah. Get on the good foot. Break it down on the scene. Yeah. I like a sex machine. I'm a sex machine. Now, I have a cup. Half a cup of the blue cheese. Half a cup. If you don't want to make, use my recipe for blue cheese, you can just use the bottle, baby. Get on the good foot, ay! Get on the good foot. I break it down on the scene, baby. I like a sex machine. I'm a sex machine. I'ma cut my heat off. I had it on low. I'ma cut my heat off. This hot ass skillet is gonna make sure it do the job. This hot ass skillet is gonna make sure it do the job. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. Aye, my nigga. A little bit of that hot sauce. Yeah. Yeah. This is what makes it Buffalo, baby. If you do not like blue cheese, substitute the blue cheese for ranch, okay? Do it like that. Keep it all ranch. But see, this is my recipe for a blue cheese dip. So it's like, I like to put blue cheese in mine, and I'm gonna put in blue cheese crumbles. The original way to eat buffalo wings is with blue cheese. We gotta keep that shit traditional. In this case, I like a sex machine. Oh, wait a minute. Ooh-wee. Yeah. Ooh-wee. Yeah. Get in there, Big Chef. You want to stir all that in there real good. Look at that. Now we are beginning to look a lot like Buffalo. Yeah, we're beginning to look a lot like Buffalo now, nigga. We got that color going on. Huh? Big Chef done put that color in there, baby. That's all it was lacking. That's all it was lacking. Now, we need some more shit. We're gonna get some cheddar. I got some already open. We're gonna use more than this though. Way more than this, probably.
Cheddar make it motherfucking better. Thank y'all so much for rocking with us this morning. We've got about 15 more minutes left in the first episode of Tailgate Week. We appreciate y'all for being here. This is Chef Kendall's Kitchen.
Yeah.
Brought to you by IC Bags, baby.
Bow, bow, bow.
You tap the screen, share the live. Man. And if you know Lola.
Hey, Lola. My nigga.
Hey, okay, Lola.
You guys follow the beautiful, the light-skinned it. Nola Lane Lane, my nigga. Hey.
The boss herself, Nola Lane Lane, baby. Ling.
All right. Let's see. I want to put some cheese in the inside, and I want to put some cheese in the top. So don't judge me. You feel me? Don't judge me.
You can catch this episode of this recipe on YT. Follow Chef Kendall on YT, and you can replay this episode. It'll be available tomorrow.
What is it? Are we recording?
We are recording, Chef. Yeah. Does that change the way how you do it?
Yeah, now I gotta be proper.
Okay.
I guess I gotta stop cussing now, huh? I did not know we were recording. When you recording?
We're about 50 minutes too late, Chef.
Well then.
Okay.
Well then, shit. So you know the real me, huh? I might as well be me, huh? Fuck
okay.
Shit. Hell, dick. I might as well cuss and do all type of things. Look, I'm gonna put some cheese in here. I want some in the inside. I want you to touch me on the inside, Pauline. Yeah. Tell me on my inside, Pauly. Shit. Beloved. 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 Ooh. 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 Yeah, I feel like Young M.A. Big Chef feel like Young M.A. Shit. Ooh. How much do I want to add? I'm not going to add the whole 4 ounces. I just want a little bit of blue cheese sprinkled throughout, baby. Because that's that traditional way. You ain't got to do it like this, though. You can do yours how you had wanted to do yours. You feel me? Shit. You can do yours how you had wanted to, how you, huh? Yeah, you can. It's in the stars that you can do it your way. Shit. Flick, 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 flick. Flick, flick. Flick, flick. Big Chef gonna flick it all in there, baby. Flick, flick. Shit. Shit, who ain't gonna flick it? I'ma flick it. In there.
Okay.
Don't make me laugh, wife. I'm being serious. I'ma flick it. Shit, don't make Big Chef laugh, baby. Alright, let's do some more cheddar. Because we need to put a top on here like a macaroni or something. You feel me? We need to put a top on him. On him. Ain't that some shit? I'm sounding like an old ass black man already. We need to put a top on him. Shit.
Okay.
I can see me already. I can't wait. Motherfucker, get your ass out my yard. Ooh, thank you. I appreciate you. Who did that? Wifey, that's you?
Yes.
Thank you. Motherfucker, get out my yard. Yeah. Get off my grass. Yeah. Get your ass over there with my collard green. I feel like we're going to start a garden. You feel me? We're going to grow our own shit. Hell yeah. A bigger garden. I mean a big garden.
I want one.
Hell yeah. For you.
I'm ready.
Fresh. You ready, boo? Let me get it real quick. I want to taste mine. Ain't no wrong with giving it a little taste because how you gonna know how that shit hit? Let's give it a taste. Woo! Love it. Fucking love it. That must be somebody important though because it wrong. My shit ain't gonna ring unless somebody important. Who that is?
Our son.
I knew it. My little boy. My motherfucking son. Calling during one of my biggest shows. Thank you, son. I should have put his ass on speakerphone. You know goddamn well. Alright. Now I wanna pile this on here tall enough to make an actual crust. I like mine to have a little crust on it. Just like you would a mac and cheese, okay? Just like you would a mac and cheese. I think this enough right here. Yeah, that's enough. Woo! Now this cheese, we'll put this in some, I don't know, maybe we'll make some tacos. I don't know. Yeah, put that back in there. Yeah. Ooh, I see a spot. Okay. Okay. We good. We good. Now, this is ready to go in the oven at 350. Nah, let's do it in the oven at 400. 400 to 450, depending on your oven. Now, in my old house, I can rock this on 450. This house, this oven, hotter than a motherfucker. So, anywhere from 400 to 450, let's rock it for 30 to 45 minutes. Keep a close eye on it. You gonna know when it's ready. I want that shit to look just like your mac and cheese. You know how your mac and cheese get that beautiful little cheesy crust? It be bubbling, it get brown and crusty at the top. The good crusty, that cheese crackling on the top. That's what you want. No, we don't have time for it now. I'm sorry. The finished results are going to be on IG and YT. You want to see what it look like? You don't trust me? You don't trust me? You want to know what it look like? Shit, go on IG, YT, and go and check it out. We're going to put it in the oven. I'm going to match mine up with some crustinis. We just going to take these, and you can cut them straight, straight down the middle, or you can cut them on the bias. I think I want to cut them on the bias a little bit. Just a little bit on a little bit of an angle, just so I can scoop better. Just cutting it on the bias. You don't have to do it like this. You don't even have to use crustinis. This is very extra, okay? This is extra. I know you in a hurry. I know you got shit to do. I know you're not trying to be a chef. I get it. So, we're just gonna take little crustinis. Non-stick pan. You don't have a non-stick pan? You need to spray it with some pan spray or whatever. But just lay them on the pan. We have about 4 loaves, so we gonna do a lot of them. But you just lay them on the pan, man. And what you can do is you can get some fresh garlic and olive oil and put it on there. Or you can do what Big Chef is gonna do. I'm just gonna go not avocado oil. Olive oil. We gonna go with the olive oil. Just a little drizzle, drizzle. Drizzle, 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 drizzle. Drizzle a little olive oil on them. Put them in the oven. Toast them up. Get them good and toasty. Pull them out. They'll cool down. They'll get even harder. You're going to use them to dip in here. You feel me? Like a big old sturdy chip. This is so much better than a tortilla chip. Man, I got some cheese on this motherfucker. I got some cheese on this month. So you're going to have to go deep. You got to get in that thing, baby. And a little old tortilla chip is not going to do it. You're going to need some bread. Huh? So we're going to go in with the crustinis, man. We're going to do it like that. Check my IG. Check my YT. Go to the website. Go to the website. Peek out the products, man. Check out the aprons, the seasons, the spoons, the towels, the cookbook. Join me all week this week. This is tailgate week, man. I'm going to be giving you your tailgate needs. These are the tailgate needs right before the football season kicks in. You know who I'm rolling with. You see who I'm rolling with. You know what I'm saying? This is tailgate season. Come see me every day this time, man. And after this time, continue to come see me. This is Chef Kendall's Kitchen, and I am your host with the most. I am Chef Kendall, man. I'm going to be giving you these visits all week, man. So y'all check in with us, man. And check in for the buy. That's our sister show. That's the second show. Me and my beautiful wifey, she headlines that, and she does all the artistic shit that we do. So y'all check that out at 2 p.m. Central. Come back and see me tonight, man. Come back and see me tonight, 9 p.m. Central for the night show. And if you can't make it to that, come back to the morning show, 11 p.m. Central, and come fuck with your host with the most. I love you. I love you. And it ain't a damn thing that you can do about it. One time for the one time, we are out this motherfucker. But we'll be back like we never left. I put that on my last breath. Yeah. To the sky. To infinity and beyond. Let me walk you out, man. I'm willing to all the ice you see. I'm willing to all of me I got. Yeah. Keisha, I appreciate you. I appreciate you, man. Thank y'all so much. Every tap. every share, every give a care. Lipstick doll, your beautiful ass. I thanking you. I'm appreciating you right now, nigga. Thank you. Gummy bear. Hey, y'all follow my gummy bear, man. Been rocking it with the beautiful gummy bear for a while, man. Y'all follow gummy bear. Thank you. I love you. It ain't a damn thing you can do about it. One time for the one time we out this bitch. I want you to go out and have a good day on purpose. Ain't that what Q say? Today was a good day. I want you to go out and have a good day, a great day, on purpose.
Just waking up in the morning, gotta thank God. I don't know, but today seems kinda odd. No barking from the dog, no small. And mama cooked the breakfast with no harm. I got my grub on, but didn't dig out. Finally got a call from a girl I wanna dig out. So hooked it up for later as I hit the dough. Thinking, will I live another 24? I gotta go, cause I got me a drop top. And if I hit the switch, I can make the ass drop. Had to stop at a red light. Looking in my mirror, not a jacker in sight. And everything is alright. I got a beat from Kim, and she can fuck all night. Called up the homies and I'm asking y'all, which part are y'all playing basketball? Get me on the court and I'm troubled. Last week fucked around and got a triple-double. Freaking niggas every way like MJ. I can't believe today was a good day. Showers. Didn't even get no static from the cowards. Cause just yesterday them bulls tried to blast me. Saw the police and they rolled right past me. No flexing, didn't even look in a nigga's direction as I ran the intersection. Went to show dog's house, they was watching you on TV raps. What the haps on the cracks? Shake em up, shake em up, shake em up, shake em. Roll em in a circle of niggas and watch me break em with the 7-11. 7-11, 7 even back door.